So yeah, be nice to security on the boat. You get nowhere if you're dirty to security. They're all super sweet guys. I've never had a bad experience with anyone in security, but I will tell you, if they need to get gruff, if they need to get like short with you, they will. And that's their job, to keep the boys safe. That's their priority. Another thing I want to mention to you guys is that security is not necessarily there to keep us safe. In fact, I'm just going to go ahead and say it. They are not there for us. Security is there for the boys. So if someone is pushing and shoving you and you're like, oh, I'm going to tell Keith that you're pushing me, or you tell Keith that someone's pushing at you, Keith is literally going to go, like, push back. Like, what do you want me to do? I kind of have to stand here and guard my boy. You know, like, that's just how it works. But yeah, don't piss them off, because it's their job to remember who's going to be a problem, right? So if you are a problem, they don't forget that the next day when you're trying to get in good graces and be nice because you want something. So be nice. Treat them well. They're so friendly, guys. They will, if you run into them and like they're not on duty, like they'll take pictures with you. They're super sweet. You can talk to them. They're amazing. So like, be nice to them. I haven't met Drew, Amber. I've like been close to him, but I've never actually talked to him. So, but I've heard that. I've heard that he's very sweet. So yeah. I mentioned that. Just making sure. I'm trying to figure out how to put a poll on the Facebook page, guys. I did figure out how to do it, but for some reason it would only let me give two options. And I was gonna do a poll just for like activities that you guys would like to see on the cruise. I know that some people have said like they'd really like to see like lip sync battle or karaoke. One of the things that I thought would be kind of fun, like maybe not like in the theater, like because that they kind of like plan those shows, but like maybe for just like a Q&A type thing on deck like they did last time. Truth or dare. I think that could be really fun. Never have I ever. I think that could be fun to play with them. Plead the fifth, where if you guys aren't familiar with what plead the fifth is, that's basically, I think you give them like 3 to 5 questions each and they have to answer all of them truthfully, but they can plead the fifth to one question. If you're not familiar with what pleading the fifth is, if you're not, you know, an American, the fifth is the Fifth Amendment of the U.S. Constitution. And basically that means that you are exercising your right to remain silent and not say anything that could further incriminate you in a court of law. So when you say, you know, you ask a question and they decide they're going to plead the fifth on that question, that means that they've chosen to not answer that question. So maybe the answer to that was going to be too scandalous or something. But yeah, I think plead the fifth could be fun. Some other fans have reached out to me and said things like Backstreet Trivia with like boys versus fans. And like, how well do you know the Backstreet Boys? So like, that was like an idea that I came up with, like have kind of like a Backstreet version of the dating game. And the boys might talk to you in like a different voice. I feel like this would, basically here's what happened, guys. I had this fantasy that we would play this game, like all of us, not just me, alone with them, by myself. That's not how I envisioned it. But basically, they would talk in like, if a Backstreet Boy was like a phone sex operator, like they're very white, like let's seductive voice, which might sound different than their regular talking voice. And it's up to the fan to figure out which Backstreet Boy is talking. And like the fan might be blindfolded or something, so like we can all see the boy, like, you know, the rest of the crowd can see what the boys are doing. So, okay, cool. They did dating game on the first cruise, but yeah, just something like that where like they kind of have to disguise their voices by talking all sexy. That was really just an excuse for me to get some of that action in my life. But yeah. So I'm working on that poll. I'm going to add some more stuff to it. As of today, we're officially 91 days. So we're almost, guys, like into like the 80s. That's crazy. I want to remind everybody that on Saturday, February 24th, Carolee from The Fangirling Life is going to be here with me live to do a vlog, the two of us together. We're going to be talking more ADA stuff. So if you're a fan who who's going to need assistance with that, going to need information on that. She'll be able to answer some of those questions pertaining to, like, the cruise itself. But we're just going to be talking about a bunch of other stuff. And so, like I said, if you're into door decorating, that might be a vlog that you definitely want to watch, because she door decorates and I don't. So, and that's going to be a Saturday at 2 p.m. Atlanta time. And so I think, just given that it's going to be on a Saturday, hopefully more of you guys can tune in. So I'm going to start, like, posting about that once you guys can let friends know. But like I said, also, she's a Nick girl. So she can kind of, she probably has way more Nick stories than the one or two that I have. And she can kind of talk to you from the perspective of being a Nick fan. Like how I can talk to you from the perspective of being a Kevin fan. It's going to be a little bit more maybe enthusiastic, and you can ask questions of her about what those have been like, and she can give you guys more information. I'm gonna save this for another vlog, just because I've already talked for like an hour at this point, but I did want to kind of like put stuff out there. I love to read, and I love listening to like audiobooks. I'm a big like romance and like paranormal romance urban fantasy reader, so I was gonna like let you guys in on some of the stuff that I might be reading, like for traveling down to the cruise or whatever, and like going to bed the night before, trying to like get zen enough to like get some of that adrenaline off so I can actually fall asleep. But I'll save that for another vlog. Next vlog, so this will be Tuesday. Some of the things I want to cover is memorable moments from beach parties. I am hoping to have my alcohol information prepared for you guys that want that info by that next vlog. I'm not going to promise that at this point, because I still need to do that research. I'm going to be talking about roommate etiquette in your cabin, like things like to definitely not do. Like if you normally sleep in the nude when you're at home by yourself in your own bed, you can't just like assume that it's going to be okay to do that when you're in a cabin with your roommate, just like butt naked. Like, don't just assume. So stuff like that we'll be talking about next vlog. And hopefully I will have gotten that poll situation sorted out for activities that you guys would like to see, so I can kind of discuss what you guys voted on. We have no say in what actually happens, but I just thought, you know, that might be kind of a fun thing to do. Last thing, I was going to save this for a vlog for much, much later, but I'm just going to go ahead and say it now. This will be real quick. This will be the last thing. If you're not cruising this year, or if you are cruising this year and you want to go on the next cruise, I would assume that this is not going to be the last one, you guys, because New Kids on the Block just announced their 10th cruise, and this is only our 6th Backstreet Boys cruise. I would assume that there's going to be another one. If I remember correctly, after like, there have been instances after cruises where they announced that there's going to be another cruise really soon after the previous cruise returns. So, like, if you are trying to save up to go on a cruise, like, start a little Backstreet fund, a little savings account. So if you've had it on your to-do list to always get on a cruise and it just doesn't seem like it's going to be feasible, I feel like this is one of those mountains that you should take in small bites, as opposed to trying to figure out how you're going to come up with the thousands of dollars all at one time. For those of you who've never cruised before, you just might not realize this. When the cruise goes on sale, There's a pre-sale the day before for fans and for past cruisers that get a special code to access that. All you need at the time of booking is your deposit. And your deposit amount is going to depend on what size, what not size, what kind of cabin you get. And that doesn't necessarily speak to whether or not you have a balcony or like a window with a view. What kind of cabin you get, I'm talking more like, does your cabin come with any Backstreet Boys cruise perks? Like, first 6 rows at the assigned seating events, or access to an exclusive event of some kind, or first row. Those are the kind of cabins that are going to be more expensive. But like for like your basic regular cabin, that deposit, you only need $300. And I say only $300, but I mean like that's not the full amount up front. And then this past cruise, Rose Tours rolled out the option to pay towards your cruise monthly, as opposed to paying in like those big increment chunks. So you can kind of do whatever works best for your budget, but like don't let the next cruise announcement catch you off guard. You know it's coming at some point. if you want to go on this cruise, start saving up now and just put money aside. Okay, Amber says that they have to do at least one more cruise with Carnival, at least with Carnival. So that's awesome. Because I'm not ready for it to ever end, you guys. I would Backstreet cruise for the rest of my life if I could. So yeah, whether you're cruising this year or not, keep like a Backstreet fund to do the Backstreet things that you want to do. I know, and I realize that I'm saying this, and some of you guys are probably rolling your eyes like, listen at Moneybags over there telling me how to spend it. Like, no, that's not what that is at all, but I'm just letting you know. I hear so many people going, oh man, they just announced this cruise. I'm like, that's the thing, guys. When they say that a cruise is going to go on sale, it's not like you know a month and a half, 2 months in advance. You're like driving, going about your life, doing your normal day stuff, and then out of the blue, out of nowhere, you get a notification from, if you follow them on social media, or an email that says, oh yeah, by the way, tickets for the next cruise go on sale on Friday. Oh, it's Tuesday at 6 p.m. So you got 3 days. That's how that works. So just like, you know, stay ready with the Backstreet money if you can do that. So yeah, that's it. Does anybody have any questions for me before I sign off this evening? I really appreciate everybody who's tuned in to this vlog and all the last ones. And I'm really glad that these have been helpful to you guys. I also realized that like I've probably looks like I've become a lot more comfortable talking to you guys, because this has like really been my first experience like talking on camera. My actual personality is coming out, so yeah. Bitch is crazy. I know. It's okay. Yeah, Amber says that she was in Vegas visiting the boys to watch a show when they announced this next cruise. So, like, they don't care. They're like, oh, you've already spent all that money on Backstreet Boys stuff? Well, you know what? You don't get to keep your pennies. We're doing a cruise, and you have 5 minutes to pay for it. It's like a stick-up. Give us all your money. And you're like, yes. But, yeah. So if no one has any questions, I'm going to go ahead and sign off. Feel free to send me questions for next time. I'll see you guys next Tuesday, same time, same place. Thanks again, and 91 days. Bye, guys.